How's it going, everyone? Welcome to my ultimate AH flipping guide. So in this video, I'm going to be giving an overview of all the different ways you can make money with AH flipping in Skyblock. There are going to be a lot of good little tricks in here that I've never seen in another video or forum post. So stick around because you'll probably learn something and it might help you make some more money. Because AH flipping is such a broad topic, it's going to be difficult to make a video that covers everything. I'm trying my best, but if I miss something, let me know in the comments. And before I get started, I've been AH flipping for about a month now. I've made all my money on my profile with AH flipping, and I think I peaked at around 10 million coins before I went and bought myself an AOTD. So you can definitely make a lot of money by doing this, and it doesn't matter if you're rich or really poor. These tactics apply to everyone, and I am aware that if this video does get big, then I will be having an impact on how effective AH flipping is overall. So if this video gets like 10,000 plus views, it might actually reduce the effectiveness of some of what I'm talking about. So just keep that in mind. Also, if I ruin your favorite AH flipping method, I'm sorry. It's in the open now. That's unlucky for you. I've narrowed down AH flipping into three subcategories: resell, crafting, and merchant flipping. I'll be explaining what each one is and the pros and cons of each. I'll also be giving examples of items that I flip commonly, and I'm going to try and keep in mind the different stages of the game: early game, mid game, late game, and end game, so that everyone can make some money by doing this. Resell. This is where you find an item that's being sold for less than market value, purchase it, and flip it for a profit. On the surface, it sounds really simple, but there's a lot of little tricks you can use to maximize your profits. Also, I thought I'd better mention that flipping on the AH and using resell and any other method isn't guaranteed money. You have to do it smart and you have to do it well, because there is always the chance that you can lose money. I've lost money, and if you start auction flipping, there is a good chance that you will lose a little bit at the start, but as you learn, you'll start to make more and more. Here are some items that I've flipped before, so I know they work. The best thing to do early game is to buy up Ender Armor pieces for 10 to 20k each, and then resell them, and you might get lucky and get 100 to 200k each. I even saw one going for 400k this morning. At mid game, there are lots of good items you can flip. Bat talismans and spider talismans are really solid. Sometimes they can go from 30 to 50k each, but other times they'll get bid way up and they'll go for 100 to 150k each. Hot potato books are another good one. Sometimes you can get them from 13 to 50k each, and they'll sell from 80 to 100k if you're lucky. Maybe even more. Crystal armor. Buy it at 10 to 20k each, try and reforge it to smart or wise, and then resell it. You can get easily upwards of 100k per piece. One that's made me a lot of money recently is buying young dragon armor. Because it just got buffed, no one really knows what price it's meant to go for. An example is I got a chest plate for 250k, enchanted it, resold it for 700k. It was some really easy profit. So now let's move on to late game or end game. Any dragon armor has potential to be a really good flip if you can get the right price for it. Here's an example. Say you buy an unstable chestplate for 600, 700k, you can enchant it, put it back on the AH for 1.1 mil to 1.2 mil. Another interesting flip that I did was buying bat person armor in between the spooky festivals for about 1 to 1.5 mil per piece. And then if you sell them right before the event starts, you can get 2, 2.5 mil per piece because people are looking to maximize their candy profits. Another good one is Mastiff armor. Sometimes the pieces can go for 1 mil, 900k, 1.2 mil. And then if you resell them, they can go from 1.8 mil to 2.2 mil. You just have to buy and sell at the right times. One of my personal favorites for making a lot of money is Tarantula Helms. This one is a bit risky, but you can make a lot of money with it. Sometimes the tarantula helms will go for 300k, 350k, and if you buy them then and sell them later when they're going for more, you can get 800k, 900k for a helm. The last resell flip that I'm going to talk about is buying purple candy in between the spooky festivals. Sometimes purple candy can go for really cheap, and if you buy it whenever you see some cheap purple candy, you can build up a collection of purple candy, and if you sell them at a stack a time when the spooky festival's happening, you can get 1.2 mil per stack. Personally, I managed to build myself up a stack of purple for about 400k in the past, and so that was about 800k profit for not that much work. So now here are some tips for reselling items that I don't usually hear. When talking about when to buy items, most people will just say, oh, sell at peak times and buy at low times. But this doesn't really work. I mean, sure, it might work for some items, but for a lot of items, it actually sells for less at peak and more at off times. I've found that armor sells for a lot more at off-peak times, and items like hot potato books sell for a lot more on-peak times. So it just depends what item you're trying to sell, and you need to figure that out to make the most profit. With resale, the most important thing is that you know the prices of pretty much every item down to the exact dollar they're worth. Because if you know the exact price, you can undercut just enough to make a good bit of profit on every flip you do. Now let's move on to crafting flips. A crafting flip is basically where you buy the components for a good flip item, you craft the item, you do whatever you need on the item to make it worth more, and then you sell the item for a really large profit, usually much bigger than the profits on reselling. One of the flips I do quite a lot is buying strong frags off the AH at 19 or 20k per, and then crafting boots. I then enchant the boots, I reforge them to something good, and I sell them on the AH for 1.2 mil, 1.3 mil, something like that. Now, if you buy all the frags at 19 or 20k per, it only costs about 800k plus the 10k to enchant it, is 810k, so you're making about 400 to 500k on every flip you do. This flip works for any type of frag. You can do it for young, wise, unstable. You can even do it for superior, and that gives you the most profit. I was talking to my guild members earlier about how you can make a lot of money by flipping superior chest plates. If you buy all the frags for 120k each, it costs 9.6 mil to buy the chest plate. Enchanting it costs basically nothing. Hot potato booking it, 700k, maybe 800k. You're looking at about 10.5 mil to get a maxed superior chestplate. Maybe 100k, 200k to reforge, 10.7 mil for a fully maxed superior chestplate. Those things can go for 15 mil. I saw one go for 17 mil. You're making a lot of profit off one flip that doesn't really take that long to do. You can also buy tarantula silk and iron off the AH, craft it into tarantula helms, and do the same thing as with resell. Enchant it, reforge it, and sell it for 800-900k at the right time. Now with both resell and crafting, there are a lot of different ways you can do this. These are just some examples that I'm listing. You have to go out and find the items that work for you the best, that make you the most money. So go out, find some items that are really good to flip, and make your own style of AH flipping. It doesn't have to all come from me. So the final type of AH flipping is the one I actually do the least, but honestly, it might be the most profitable if you do it consistently. And that is merchant flipping. So what merchant flipping is buying items from the NPCs at spawn, crafting them into something, and selling it on AH for a profit. Now the reason I do this the least is because I'm lazy. Doing this takes a lot of clicking, you just sit there, you click on materials, I can't be bothered. But if you're looking for a consistent way to make money, this is probably the best AH flipping you're gonna get. There are a lot of good examples of merchant flipping, so here are a couple. Buying potatoes from the farm merchant and crafting hot potato books. You can buy all the potatoes for 60k and you can sell the hot potato book for 100k, 110k, sometimes less, sometimes more. It's still a lot of good profit. You can also flip the items that are required to craft Slayer components. So for Revenant Viscera, it would be enchanted string. For Golden Teeth, it would be enchanted gold. And for Tarantula Silk, it would be enchanted flint. You can buy all these items from merchants, and if you sell them on the AH, they go for a lot more than what you buy them for. I would definitely recommend selling them a stack at a time, because no one wants to buy less than a stack. Essentially, the most important thing about merchant flipping is buying items that are in high demand. If it's in low demand, no one's gonna bid it up and no one's gonna pay a premium for those items. It's the items that everyone wants and needs a lot of that are going to be bid up a lot. Now that I've covered all that, I figured I should make a section for the endgame players, the people looking to make millions in one flip that have 20, 30 million in the bank, that are very rich and looking to make more money through the auction house. Now, I'm not an endgame player, I've only ever had 10 mil in the bank at once, so I haven't tried these flipping methods myself, but based on everything I know about the auction house, they should definitely work, and they should be really effective. Now, the first one I would recommend would be enchanting AOTDs and 50 mil Midases. So buy a clean AOTD or Midas, enchant it, hot potato book it, and put it back on the AH for more money. You will make quite a lot of profit doing this because people will pay extra to not have to worry about enchanting. Now, it goes without saying that you would want to keep the anvil uses on these items as low as possible. I would say 1 or 2 at max. Because people pay more for less anvil use items, and so the more anvil uses have, the less profit you're going to be making. I would also recommend dark auction flipping. If you can get into a dark auction and buy some of the items for cheap, usually dark auction items go for much more on the AH than they do at the actual auction. So there's a lot of potential there to make some profit with dark auction flipping. So that's about it for this video. If you learned something that you didn't already know, please consider subscribing because there'll be more content like this coming very soon. I hope this helped you guys. Thank you for watching.